happy? Are you saying hi to the camera? Diaz.
What you got in there, a little poopy? Oh, big poopy.
You did a poopy, Enzo. I know, it's okay. She's gonna change your diaper, mommy. It's okay. He looks so pretty, Cora. Buenos dias. Okay, you gotta let go so I can do this though. I know. But okay.
Hey, that was a disgusting poop, by the way. Why are you pooping grain? Pooping grain and sticky. I have to peel it off your butt.
Ben K. Alex, since they recognize their bottles.
It's okay. Okay, you look fabulous.
You gonna let us sleep one night one day? Or you just trying to break us? It feels like you work for me, you don't sleep. He's like, I don't sleep, you don't sleep. You understand?
Where are you going, puppy? Where are you going? He's so nosy.
It's happened for 5 minutes, he doesn't move. The second I stop, he's like...
Yeah, he lifts himself up like a little lizard.
He turns
lizard.
Around.
Yeah.
And then he does. No.
No, it's not playtime.
Let's play going to sleep.
Let's play going to sleep.
First one to close their eyes wins.
All right, girl.
Good job, Enzo.
All
good
done.
Job.
He's a little dinosaur. Guys, so now that we fed them, what we usually do is start logging everything. We use the Huckleberry app to log everything that they do, so their diaper changes, their feedings, the solids that they eat, their sleep. So I go ahead and stop their timer because we started a timer last night for So they woke up at 7:30. Would you like to say something? So then we go and log Cora. She also woke up at 7:30. And then we log their feeding. So they finished like 10 minutes ago. They're drinking 7 ounces right now. Oh my god, this is so cute. They're holding hands. Are you guys holding hands? He already spit up on our bed. Are you guys holding hands? Okay, so now that everything is logged, what we tend to do is we co-sleep with them for their first nap of the day, I guess. They always go back to sleep at this time. So they tend to sleep with us. They sleep in their crib for the whole night and all of that. But in the morning after we feed them, we just cuddle up with them in our bed. And yeah, so we're about to like take another nap with them. It is 8:15 a.m. So they'll sleep for another maybe hour, 2 hours. It just depends on how tired they are. Last night they each did wake up in the middle of the night, which they've been doing lately because they're teething, so like it's been uncomfortable for them.
Yeah, do a tummy. Cora got a good luck tummy. I rub your tummy for good luck, baby. Are you kicking me in the face?
Okay, so the twins woke up, and now I'm gonna start getting myself together. I'm gonna do my skincare routine while they are, ooh, it's so nice out today. I'm gonna do my skincare routine while they're in the kitchen with Morgan, and then we usually do a little solids feed before their next bottle, which is in like 2 hours. They're eating 7 ounces every like 4 hours right now, and they probably have like 4 feeds a day. Before, you know, they go back down for the night. So we did one in the morning, and now we're gonna do some solids, and then they do another feeding, and then usually they take like another nap. So I'll take you guys through my day and show you how that works.
You know what they look like? They look like the things from the...
The foosball?
Guy. Yeah. Because their legs stick together. You guys are playing foosball with the twins.
I'm about to prepare their cereal. I'm about to prepare their oatmeal for breakfast. And I'm gonna have some oats too. Morgan already had breakfast while I was doing my skincare. And this is the oats that I give them. It's the same. It's the same brand as the formula that they have, or it's best. So I got them the same cereal, and I just pour in like a tablespoon of that with a scoop of formula and some water, enough to give it like a applesauce consistency. And that's what they have for breakfast, but then later on I'll give them like actual solids, like food. But for breakfast I like starting them with a little bit of oatmeal, and I usually mash. In the beginning I did it plain, and now I do like a little bit of banana and a sprinkle of cinnamon, just to get them used to like different flavors and stuff. So that's what I'm gonna do right now.
It's just the twins, girl. Nobody's recording you. They just woke up. She's not camera ready.
Nope. Well, you better put your legs in the thing. Damn. Strawberries.
I'm giving them the strawberries.
She said this only is not good.
And a strawberry is? Look, he's eating it by himself.
Oh wow.
He just has it.
Good job,
man. So Laura likes to put her face into the food.
What's OOTD.
Outfit of the day. Wow, Morgan.
Sorry. I don't watch
that. That's not even where it's from. That's not where it's from. It's an internet thing.
Yeah, Morgan.
It's all
internet
the same
thing.
Vibe.
That's old though. Like, that's very old hashtag.
Yeah, Morgan, go with the program. You know NFTs, but you don't know OT.
Wow. It be your own.
I'm still catching
up. It really be your own. You want a fresa? Fresa? Get a mask? See? Mask?
Do you want a strawberry quick? You want a strawberry?
Time for them to take a nap, so
excuse you.
So we are going to change their diapers and put them down.
The stress poop. You stressed, Cora? What are you stressed about, baby?
She's not stressed.
Is that relaxed poop? Because it smells stressed.
So that is like analyzing it to be
terrible. Foul play, girl. Red card.
Okay. Now that the twins are napping, we can chat. The twins usually take a nap from anywhere from an hour to an hour and a half. It just depends, because now that they're teething, obviously that adds another layer. They're turning 6 months in a few days, and right now Cora has like two teeth coming out and Enzo has one that you can see already as well, and teething has been insane. Basically right now the teething is a thing. They obviously started eating solids, which is a new thing. In the morning, I give them oats, which you guys saw, and that's usually how they start between their two feeds, like the morning one and the second one of the day. They have oatmeal and maybe like fruit, like banana or strawberry, and then they take their second nap, because the first one is the one where we co-sleep. So usually, today's Sunday, but usually if it's a weekday, by the time we wake up with them from their first nap, then Morgan starts getting ready for work and he starts work from home, and then I'm alone with the twins. But because today is Sunday, obviously we're doing all these things together throughout the day. So after their second nap right now, we usually do like playtime, and that means like going on the little play gym, which I'll show you guys, and they do tummy time and they play and they reach for things and grab things, and I try to give them independent play as well as, you know, like supervised play where I engage with them and do kind of, you know, little activities. Cora's personality is definitely a little more independent, and then Enzo is a little more needy in things, especially now that he's teething. He's like super needy, but they are a little different. Even though they're twins, like you can already tell that they have like different personalities, and they've kind of been like that since the beginning. I want to say that like from the day they came home from the hospital to now, their personalities have kind of stayed the same. So Enzo's always the one that like needs a little more attention, and he likes being held a little more. He's less likely to like play independently and be chill like on his own, whereas Cora could like spend time on her own, and she knows how to like just be chill being by herself. So last night we each decided who has who before we go to bed, so we alternated every night. And last night I had Cora and Morgan had Enzo, and then the following night, like tonight, I'll have Enzo and he'll have Cora. So we like switch it up. I think that like as soon as you get into a flow, like they like switch it up on you, and then you're like starting from scratch with something else. But it's like crucial to have a routine. Like I think when I had Liana 12 years ago, I definitely don't remember having any routine for her. And I think like singleton parents can afford that, but like I can't. Like twin parents, you need a routine, because they need to be on the same schedule. Otherwise you're like taking care of a twin around the clock,
And that's not fun at all because you have no time for yourself. So, like, you have to have a nap schedule, the feeding schedule. Like, everything has to be in routine. And my Virgo rising ass definitely thrives on that because love me a good routine and love order. And I love feeling like I'm in control, which is why, like, I use the app, the Huckleberry app, because it lets me, like, keep track of everything, especially with two babies and, like, sleep deprivation. I tend to forget, like, what happened and if Morgan's in care of them or I am. And, like, that's how we, like, let each other know without letting each other vocally know what has been going on when we weren't around, you know? Like, I look at the app and I'm like, okay, he changed there this long ago, you know, etc. I think we just, like I said, our routine is definitely something that we thrive on because without it, it just, everything would fall apart. And there are days, obviously, that still feel chaotic where they don't nap well or, like, we're out and, like, you know, the schedule changes a bit and things like that, obviously. But for the most part, when we're home and, like, a regular day, it's just like we keep this routine going and it looks like how I showed you guys. And now that they're sleeping, when I usually catch up with things for myself, like tidying up around the house or taking a shower or eating or just anything that I need to do, like if I'm gonna go out with them, this is when I get ready for me to go out. Like I pack their diaper bag and pick their outfits and all that stuff. So usually during their nap is when I do things. I can do some things while they're awake, but you know, they're getting older, so they require more of my presence and my attention. So it's not easy to always like get something done when they're awake. Let me keep doing my makeup because I'm over here yapping. Morgan went grocery shopping right now and I'm here while the twins nap getting ready. And then when he gets back, he's gonna be with the twins for the afternoon because usually on Sundays is when I take a few hours of the day to work on whatever I need to work on because it takes time to like edit videos and like create content and things like that. So on Sundays is when we decided to dedicate time for myself, for me to work on those things and my brand. All right, I'm gonna stop yapping and finish this makeup so that I can come back and then we can keep talking because at this rate, I'm not gonna finish. So they've been sleeping for like an hour right now. It's 2:17 and they'll probably sleep for another 20 to 30 minutes if I'm lucky. So now that I'm done with my makeup, I'm just gonna go ahead and make the bed and throw on some clothes because I'm still in my robe. You know how it is, mom life. Oh my god, this thing is crack. Okay, get with it. This thing is like a sleeping mask, but I definitely just put it on all day long because the way it keeps my lips hydrated, I'm obsessed with this thing. Okay, so I'm gonna make my bed and I'm probably gonna eat something else because now I'm hungry again and hopefully I have time to do all those things while they sleep, so. Okay, but can we talk about how guys make the bed versus how women make the bed? Because not for nothing, like, what is that? What is this? What is going on here? I'll be right back, because that ain't it. That is not it. Okay, you see what I'm saying? Like, that's a difference. And don't get me wrong, my house is a mess. Like, right below me, look at this. This is all my laundry, okay? Like, I know my house be looking nice and cute and stuff on IG, but don't be fooled, okay? I got little corners of shamefulness up in here. Oh my god, I almost forgot to do my edges. Lay left my edge brush where she shouldn't have left it. Her grandma's house. I have a daughter, they said. Can you open this for me? I can't do it with one hand, obviously. Oh my god, Lay, you want to do my edges?
Sure. Sit down.
Lay learned how to do her edges, so let's see how this goes. I used to do her edges for her, and now let's see. I'm ready to be impressed.
Maybe, maybe not. I've only done them on myself, nobody else.
She has her toothbrush, but I have like an actual edge brush and I've been looking for it for like a minute and I'm like, where's my edge brush? Lo and behold. And I asked you for it before too. And you were like, I don't know. Yes, I did. I was like, I don't know.
I just never told you. I forgot.
Okay,
I
came you don't gotta hold my head so hard. I'm not going anywhere.
Messing up my brows. Going places.
Who's that's going places? She says, skirt. Swerve.
Swerve. You ain't got no edges.
Yo, it really be your own. I swear to God.
They I'm levitating. About
to fire you from this job.
It wasn't a job. It was an offer.
It out. Ooh, it sure feels nice to have the dishes done when you're about to make food. Shout out to Leanne. I think I'm just gonna make some eggs and maybe a little coffee to like wake myself up. Actually, my water bottle just said calm down, man. I need to drink water. I'll tell myself like you can have your coffee after you've had like X amount of water, or like two of the bottles, you know, have two full bottles of water before you give yourself permission kind of to like have the coffee. Just like a little, you know, mind trick I have to play on myself. That's where we're at right now. But like I also need coffee, you know what I mean? Anyway, I'm gonna fill this up, have my water, and then I'll treat myself to some coffee. All right, so that's the plan. Let's get it. Been an hour and 45 minutes and they're still sleeping. And that's all the time I have, folks. See you next time. I'm kidding. I'm gonna go grab them.
Hi. How was your nap? Hi, guys. You look so cute.
All right, so I'm gonna eat right now. They woke up. They slept close to 2 hours, like I said, but I guess I jinxed it. So I brought them here to the play gym, and they're basically gonna do some independent play while I finish eating my meal here. So let's see how this goes, because they're kind of a little fussy because they woke up from their nap. All right, so now it's playtime in the Love Every Play Gym, which I'm obsessed with because it has so many things. I like that both of them fit. Enzo's on one. I like that both of them fit on the mat, because I was concerned about that at first, since obviously I have two babies. I was concerned if they would like fit and like be able to play together here, and so far so good. So because Enzo's teething, he's just a little more fussy. I'm holding him so that he can play with the sensory stuff while Cora does some tummy time. All right, so I'm gonna wrap up this video here. Thank you so much for coming along with me to this little morning routine and how we spend like our Sundays together. Morgan just got back from Trader Joe's, and it's now time for the twins to be with dad while I work on some things for my brand and some editing and things like that. I've been drinking my water, so I treated myself to a nice little coffee finally, which I need for a little pick-me-up. So I'm gonna work, and then we'll wrap up the night by putting them to bed and trying to get some dinner in together, and hopefully they go down easily, because like I said, with the teething, it's been a little crazy these days. But yeah, thank you guys for coming along. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you aren't already, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye.